between the moment when you start designing an aeroplane and the moment when it starts firing, you know, boop, 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 boop in the air and so on, is going to be 3 years or so. So towards the end of the war, we were actually designing civil aeroplanes. It was quite clear that nothing we'd started designing then was going to be flying in time to be any use in the war. So, in fact, I spent 3 or 4 years designing civil stuff, the end. Which was rather frustrating, actually, but there it is.
And you were using your mathematical skills then?
Yes, I was not only using mathematical skills. I don't regret the engineering training, in a way. In fact, I don't regret it at all, really. It teaches you that mathematics, how to use mathematics. I mean, how to... It first of all teaches you a great faith in mathematical models. I mean, I don't know whether you realise this, but up till the 1950s, certainly all the time when I was designing aeroplanes, we designed aeroplanes very successfully on one of the assumptions we made was that air is incompressible. Now, everybody knows, everybody pumped up a bicycle tire knows that air is compressible, but the assumption was that air was incompressible, and it's a perfectly safe assumption to make when designing an aeroplane, so long as it doesn't go close to the speed of sound, which in those days we didn't. In other words, I learnt that you can make models making assumptions about that air is incompressible, that metals obey Hooke's law, which are safe enough to trust your life to. You know, you can go up in the aeroplanes and they don't crash. And so I learnt to how to make models and to put faith in models, which is not... I don't think I learnt any new mathematical techniques as an engineer. The one thing I'll say for Eton is they taught me a lot of straight mathematics, but it did teach me how you apply mathematics to the real world and to put faith in models of the real world.